In this video, we are going to discuss about IGCT, that is Insulated Gate Commutator Thyristor. So IGCT is the new member in the power semiconductor family. It was invented in 1997 and it was introduced by ABB. It is a special type of GTO thyristor. So similar to GTO, it is a fully controllable power switch, that is it can be turned on and turned off by applying a gate signal, okay, as in the case of GTO. We can turn on the device by giving the positive gate signal, and we can turn off the device by giving a negative gate signal. So it has lower conduction losses as compared to GTO thyristors. Then it withstands higher rates of voltage rise, that is dV by dt. So snubber circuits are not required for most of the applications, because to reduce this dV by dt rating, so to protect the device from this high dV by dt, we will use snubber circuits. So here, since it withstands this higher voltage rise, this snubber circuits are not required. Next, construction. So it is same as GTO. In construction wise also it is same as GTO. So now in this video I am not going to explain in detail about the construction of IGCT, because the construction of GTO already we have seen in the previous video. Anyhow, I will give some a brief explanation about the specific differences which are available in IGCT. Okay, so this is the construction. This is the symbol of GTO, anode and cathode and gate. Okay, the same as GTO except this symbol. This is the picture of IGCT. So the structure of IGCT is very similar to GTO thyristor. In an IGCT, the gate turn-off current is greater than the anode current. So the turn off time is very short. The main difference compared with the GTO thyristor is a reduction in cell size. Okay, so it is compact in cell size combined with a much more substantial gate connection, resulting in a much lower inductance in the gate drive circuit and drive circuit connection. The very high gate currents and the fast dI by dt rise of the gate currents, okay, it has. So we cannot use regular wires to connect the gate drive to the IGCT. Okay, so for this what we are going to do, the drive circuit PCB is integrated into the package of the device. Okay, it is inbuilt. The drive circuit surrounds the device and a large circular conductor is used. The large contact area and short distance reduces both the inductance and resistance of the connection. So there are two types in IGCT. Okay, first one is with reverse blocking capability. Second one is without reverse blocking capability. Okay, so the IGCTs which are capable of blocking the reverse voltage is known as symmetrical IGCT. Okay, it is used in current source inverters. And the IGCT which is incapable of blocking reverse voltage is known as asymmetrical IGCT. Okay, it has reverse breakdown rating in tens of volts or less. Okay, so such IGCTs are used where either a reverse conducting diode is applied in parallel, okay, for this reverse blocking, or where reverse voltage would never occur. Okay, so since it has it is incapable of reversing incapable of blocking reverse voltage, okay, it can be fabricated with a reverse conducting diode in the same package. Okay, so this type of IGCT is called reverse conducting IGCT. The applications of IGCT. So these are the applications. Now you may not be knowing about these applications, but in the forthcoming subjects or in the forthcoming semesters you will study about all these things. Okay, so IGCTs can be used in medium voltage drives, marine drives, cogeneration, wind power converters, STATCOMs, dynamic voltage restorers, battery energy storage systems, solid state breakers, DC traction line boosters, traction power compensators. So these are all the applications of IGCT. Thank you.